The only bad thing about me is maybe
hard to meet,
but like,
yeah, you went somewhere like, what's that, the whole country,
you naturally.
Oh, yeah. Great crest of green round the
Ladies and gentlemen, I hate to say it, but Frankie Boy was right. I called this on my live stream yesterday. Here is that clip. Have you seen sv3rige eating raw pig head in front of the vegan festival? Yeah, I did see that video, and the one, I mean, I think it's great for like to get views on YouTube, but the problem is, okay, you're going to a vegan festival and eating raw meat and arguing with people. That's not the most, I mean, that's not the best way to go about your message. What I would do is I would probably set up a white tablecloth with a bunch of steaks and have a grill next to me and offer vegans consulting services with a free steak involved of why a vegan diet isn't good. That's what I would do. I would keep it very passive and be nice about it and make sure it's legal. But guys, if I went down to a vegan festival, there was a vegan event on Randall's Island in New York City, last year, and me and my buddy were gonna go down there, and we were thinking about pretending to be vegans and recording it, but it was such short notice we decided not to do it because I didn't have my new camera. I didn't have a camera at the time to film it, but we were gonna go to this vegan festival and just fuck around, but. Guys, I would never go in front of a vegan festival and start picking fights with people and eating. First of all, in New York City, that's a great way to get arrested. And two, that's a great way for some lunatic to like hit you in the back of the head with a brick or something. So to me, listen, if he wants to do that, I think there's a big risk associated with that. And I think something negative will happen in the future. It really depends on how you go about it. And we know how Frankie Boy would do in jail. Ugh. This isn't the first time that I've brought this up. Thankfully, there was no confrontation, nobody was hurt, it was just him getting arrested. What has to be understood is when you do something crazy, it can be met with equal craziness. Eating a raw squirrel in front of a vegan event? You don't think it would be too unusual if someone came up to you and started attacking you? I mean, when you create an environment, a chaotic environment with people, it's just getting reactions from people is so much easier. When you're in that high energy public environment, high stress confrontation, that's where bad things happen. And if sv3rige was constantly going to put himself in one of the highest levels of that type of situation possible, I mean, what do we really expect? I mean, if he did that in New York City, I'm sure he'd be arrested instantly. Apparently that's what happened in London too. These larger cities don't really have tolerance for that type of stuff. It's going to just, you know, cause too much drama, cause too many issues. But I think he's getting the message out there. I mean, is this achieving his goal? I don't really know if this is what he wanted. I mean, he won't need too much money in prison, right, ladies and gentlemen? That's kind of silly. He made the video the other day saying he didn't have enough money to travel to these places, but now I guess this stirred up so much shit that I'm sure people are going to donate him more money and people are going to become more aware of his YouTube channel. Therefore, people are going to become more aware of the carnivore movement. And depending on how big this story goes, I was like smiling when I saw this. I was like, well, I think sv3rige got what he wanted. Because what did he think was going to happen doing this? Going to a vegan festival and eating raw meat in front of, you know, pig's heads, whole chickens, raw squirrels in front of vegans? If his goal wasn't to get arrested, can someone please explain what it was? I mean, as I said in my live stream the other night, you know, I would have probably set up a table like Peter Luger style, started cooking some steaks, you know, invite some vegans to a little nice fine dining dinner, get some skinny vegan girls with daddy problems to go on a date with Frankie Boy, have a little fun here and there. You know, give me some, you know, guys, I work hard. Come on, cut me some slack. But the point is, I would have gone about it differently. Now, the way he went about it, is he achieving his goal? I don't know. I think trying to talk to vegans is completely impossible in itself, especially at a vegan event. I think the type of vegan that would go to these events is going to be someone that's going to be very hard to get out of their ideology. And we see it all the time. You know, vegans don't leave veganism until they're about to die. And some of them do actually suffer severe negative health consequences and they never step out of the haze. But hey, I guess, you know, let's give some support to our buddy sv3rige. He got what he wanted. One interesting thing about this is that these vegans always protest, like butcher shops, steakhouses, things like that. But now we're kind of turning the tables on them. And I think this vegan movement has to be met with things like this. If vegans are going to protest butcher shops, protest certain movements, then we should either be protesting their movements or like vegan restaurants, shouldn't we? But how crazy would it be that someone is standing outside of a vegan restaurant saying, oh, plant lives matter? Like, it would be a joke, right? It's just, when you turn the tables and try to think logically with these people, it doesn't really make much sense. But the overall message that he's trying to spread is that a vegan diet causes malnutrition, malnourishment, and just turning people onto that idea will get them exploring more. And the more people that go on a vegan diet, the more people will realize that it is not nutritionally adequate. The more involved we are in this movement against the vegan diet, the quicker it will be extinguished. And the vegan diet is going to be gone. Whether it's a matter of 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years, the vegan diet is going to be deemed not suitable for human life. Whatever period of time that takes, I don't know. That's going to be determined by the community and how we can fight against it. So if you guys want to understand more about why a vegan diet is not nutritionally adequate, I will link a bunch of videos at the end here. Outside of that, you guys enjoy the rest of the weekend.